are dealing with advanced technology.
This.
A former journalist claimed that military robots killed 29 people in a lab in Japan. It may seem bizarre, but a robot apocalypse isn't just limited to science fiction movies anymore. The development and creation of lethal autonomous weapons have raised concerns about the potential threat that artificial intelligence could pose to humanity. Elon Musk has long warned of the potential danger of AI. As we head towards a future where machines are making life or death decisions, the question remains, is it ever acceptable for a machine to kill a human? And who would bear the accountability? Picture this, you wake up one day, make yourself a cup of coffee, then sit down to read the news. And the first headline you come across is of military robots turning on their creators and killing 29 people in a lab. No, this isn't the plot of a science fiction movie, but rather a chilling reality that took place in a top robotics company in Japan. Well, according to a former journalist turned ufologist, Linda Moulton Howe, it happened like that. She brought this story to light in a speech back in 2018, and it's making headlines once again. It's important to note that the story is unsubstantiated and likely fake. The whole theory is based on a phone call the former journalist had with a supposed CIA agent who told her, "This is serious blank, Linda, but you're not going to hear about it in the news. It's been years, and no one has been able to corroborate it." Some media outlets suggest that it may have been fabricated to generate attention for House conspiracy theories. However, the concept of autonomous killer robots is not entirely far-fetched. In fact, in Libya in 2020, there were reports of AI-equipped drones being used to target and attack fleeing militias. It's pretty wild to think about, but apparently this new Turkish quadcopter drone called Kargu-2 can find, track, and even kill human targets on its own using facial recognition and AI. The thing is, the UN report actually referred to these drones as autonomous killer weapons, programmed to attack targets without requiring an operator to communicate with them. So basically, they were like killer robots. While we may not be in imminent danger of a robot uprising, such advancements in technology are certainly a cause for concern. Entrepreneur Elon Musk has long warned of the potential threat that AI could pose to humanity. Talking about artificial intelligence, Musk once said, "As AI gets probably much smarter than humans, the relative intelligence ratio is probably similar to that between a person and a cat, maybe bigger. I do think we need to be very careful about the advancement of AI." Lethal autonomous weapons are no longer just a plot device in science fiction movies like Terminator or RoboCop. In fact, they're already in use. The Samsung SGR-A1 Sentry Gun, deployed along the South Korean border, is reportedly capable of firing autonomously. Meanwhile, BAE Systems' Tyrannus drone, which can carry intercontinental air-to-air and air-to-ground ordnance and incorporate full autonomy, is being developed in the UK. And it's not just drones. Russia and the US are also developing robotic tanks that can operate remotely or autonomously. But as we head towards a future where machines are making life or death decisions, the question remains, is it ever okay for a machine to kill a human? We know that militaries around the world are pouring billions of dollars into creating autonomous weapons that can operate without human intervention. For instance, the US alone spent around $18 billion on autonomous weapons between 2016 and 2020. But while this technology may seem impressive, it's also incredibly dangerous. Without proper regulation, experts warn that these weapons could destabilize global nuclear strategies and increase the risk of preventative attacks. Human rights organizations are working tirelessly to prevent the development of these disruptive machines. But will they succeed before it's too late? Imagine it yourself, a machine designed to make life and death decisions with no human intervention or oversight. That's the reality of autonomous weapons, and it's a growing concern for military experts and human rights advocates alike. These machines have no conscience and no sense of right or wrong. And as studies have shown, even the most advanced algorithms can make catastrophic errors that spread quickly across populations. For instance, a neural network used in a Pittsburgh hospital mistakenly identified asthma as a risk reducer in pneumonia cases. And Google's image recognition software classified African Americans as gorillas. Bizarre, right? Similarly, Amazon's machine learning tool systematically assigned negative scores to women who applied for jobs. These algorithmic errors not only affect individuals but entire populations, and their makers often struggle to understand why they occurred and how to fix them. This black box problem of AI is what makes it almost impossible to create autonomous weapon systems that are morally responsible. Now, picture this for a second. A war crime has been committed, but there is no human culprit to be found. The perpetrator, an autonomous weapon. The question is, who takes the blame? Is it the weapon itself, the soldier operating it, the commanding officers, or perhaps the corporation responsible for its creation? The lack of clear answers to these questions has experts in international law and non-governmental organizations deeply concerned about the potential accountability gap created by autonomous weapons. Just imagine the scenario: no one to hold accountable. It's the perfect crime. This would severely weaken the laws of war and their power to deter war crimes. We need regulations that mandate meaningful human control of autonomous weapons before it's too late. Elon Musk is one of the leading opposers of armed automated robots. 2023 kicked off with a bang, as after the launch of ChatGPT, people around the world were buzzing with excitement over the potential of artificial intelligence. But while many were caught up in the hype, Musk had a sober warning. Without proper safety measures in place, AI could be our undoing. He's not talking about the Terminator movies. He means serious harm to humanity. It might seem strange that someone who has done so much for technological innovation would be skeptical about AI, but Musk has always been clear that we need regulations to keep it in check. He's even gone so far as to say that AI is a greater threat to civilization than nuclear weapons. At a speech in Dubai, Musk reiterated his concerns about the lack of safety protocols for AI. He compared it to the way we have regulations in place for seatbelts in cars and medical procedures, acknowledging the potential for harm that comes with new technologies. It's not just talk either. Musk helped found OpenAI to help ensure that humans have a say in the development of AI. Right before we jump into the last part, if you made it this far, be sure to like and subscribe for more content like this. Elon Musk isn't the only one sounding the alarm about the dangers of killer robots. A group of 116 brilliant minds from 26 different countries, including Elon Musk and Alphabet's Mustafa Suleiman, are banding together to urge the United Nations to put an end to the development and use of killer robots. And they're not just blowing hot air. The UN recently voted to begin formal discussions on these killer robots, which could include everything from drones to tanks to automated machine guns. The founders of AI and robotics companies have penned an open letter to the UN, warning that the third revolution in warfare could be just around the corner if we don't act now. The potential harm of autonomous weapons is not just a figment of imagination. Some experts believe that killer robots could be deployed within the next few years, not decades. While AI could be used to make battlefields safer for military personnel, experts fear that offensive weapons operating on their own could result in even greater loss of innocent human life. It's not just the tech leaders who are concerned about this, but also professors like Toby Walsh, a leading expert on AI. He acknowledges that technology has the potential to do great good, from solving inequality and poverty to addressing climate change and financial crises. But he also recognizes that we need to make a choice about the future we want, one where AI is used for good, or one where autonomous weapon systems are allowed to flourish and eventually take over. Ryan Garapi, the founder of ClearPath Robotics, echoed these concerns. He stated that unlike other manifestations of AI that are still in the realm of science fiction, autonomous weapons are already being developed and pose a very real threat to innocent people and global stability. It's time for us to take proactive measures to regulate AI before it's too late. As Musk has repeatedly warned, AI poses a significant threat to humanity if left unchecked, and we need to listen to smart people like him. We have the power to decide whether we want AI to help us solve the world's pressing problems, or whether we want it to industrialize war and cause harm to innocent people. Do you think automated weapons and killer robots should be allowed to dominate the battlefield? Let us know in the comments. Be sure to check this video over here.